Hi, folks. Well, we're going to continue in our discussion on the reasons the oneness theory is dangerous. People want to be New Agers. It's all going to be great, isn't it? We're all going to grow in Christ and it's going to be a new world, you know, a new age, and it's going to be so wonderful because we're all going to grow up into Christ, who is God in flesh, making us gods. Hope you see what's wrong with that. So, if people want to dance in the realm of the astrologers, I'll dance with you. I'll dance with you. The first thing we have to do is we have to nail down the difference between astronomy and astrology. They're not the same thing. Astronomy is the study of the universe and its contents outside of the Earth's atmosphere. So astronomy looks out, measures, and, you know, the about every 2100 years, 2160 years, there's a progression of the rotation of the Earth, its position in the universe. So that rotation, that full 2100 year rotation, is divided up into 12 sections, and those are your zodiacs. Your zodiac signs are, you know, Pisces, Cancer, Aquarius, Taurus. They're all parts of this rotation, and men observe that. You know, you can walk outside and observe that. You can look at it. You can see how everything is rotating, but it takes a long time to go through a full rotation. So astronomy studies that. Astrology, on the other hand, makes predictions having to do with the lives of men based on astronomy. So, astrologers, they look at the positions of the stars. They look at the motions of the stars. They look at the properties of the stars. You know, Taurus is the bull, you know. Each of those zodiacs have a property ascribed to them. And the astrologers, well, they figure, try to deduce the effects of these movements on people's lives and on events on planet Earth. It's a nasty business, to tell you the truth. The Lord says in His Word that He despises this kind of stuff. This is, He warns us, don't do it. Are we capable of doing it? Well, sure we are. But the heavens, the constellations, they're all things created by God. They're not God. They don't dictate anything to us. People have different views on that. So, We were discussing in that in the comments section of the Oneness video, someone made mention and quoted a song done by the, I think it was the Fifth Dimension, back in 69, I don't know, somewhere in there. And they quoted the lyrics. I'm going to read the lyrics to you, what they quoted, and we're going to discuss it. Because the song is called Aquarius, or the Age of Aquarius, or Let the Sun Shine In. You know, it comes many different titles on the internet, all the same song. But the song is based on astronomy, not astrology. Well, partly on astrology, but the part I'm going to read to you is based on astronomy. So it's not a lie. You know, these things can be measured. We can measure what house, what zodiac a certain age is in this 2160-year progression to move around. It says, when the moon is in the seventh house and Jupiter aligns with Mars, then peace will guide the planet and love will steer the stars. This is the dawning of the Age of Aquarius. Okay. Is there any truth in that?
Yeah, there is.
Do they know what they're talking about? Yes, the moon will be in the seventh house, and the Jupiter does align with Mars, and at one point in this rotation, and peace will rule the planet, and love will steer the stars. There's no question about that. That's true. It's true. But then they go on and they say, harmony with understanding, sympathy and trust abounding, no more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelation, and the mind's true liberation. And that's a load of bullshit. That's astrology. Making a prediction of what this means when the stars are in a certain place. Now, how can I say that? Well, I use the Bible as my guide for everything. I believe that every secret that ever existed, is the Bible reveals it, because I believe the Bible is the Word of God. And I believe that no lie comes from the Word of God. Now, do men monkey with scripture? And yes, certainly they do. Certainly they do. But a person, you know, a student of scripture, we have a tendency of searching. We don't, you know, I like the old 1984 edition of the NIV. I despise the 2011 edition of the NIV. They made some changes in the 2011 edition that are just disgusting. You know, I won't abide it. I won't buy that Bible. I like the King James. I have to admit, there are some new King James versions that I don't like. Ignorant men have made deductions and made changes that, no, don't fit well with old Ed. I study the Tanakh, the Hebrew, the Jewish Old Testament. There's a lot of Bibles I don't have a problem with. Ultimately, what defines the Word of God? Well, when everything lines up, that defines the Word of God. So in using the Word of God, to interpret, to understand mysteries. We find that the moon in Scripture is identified as the faithful witness. In the night, actually, the faithful witness in the night. But, you know, Jesus said nighttime is coming when no one can work. And that's not a lie. That's true. Nighttime is the time of darkness. Darkness is ignorance. And light is understanding. So when the day dawns, our understanding changes. From the old literal perspective to the new spiritual perspective. Spiritual meaning truthful, because it comes from the Spirit who is truth. I hope you're keeping up. Spiritual understanding has nothing to do with my heart. Nothing. God is Spirit. And this Spirit we call God is truth. Father Truth. Father Truth is invisible, but he's all-powerful. He is everywhere. He fills the entire cosmos. He is the creator of everything. Now ask yourself, did Truth create everything? Well, I'd have to be an absolute moron to deny that. You know what I mean? Like, So Ed, in the Bible, says that God is truth. Well, yeah, David, King David in the Psalms said the same thing. Remember these little things I put on the screen, these scriptures? If you are astute enough to take your Bible and look them up, you'll see that what's coming out of my mouth is exactly what the Bible says. There's a reason I put them on the screen, although I know a few people go there and, you know, that few people have their Bibles with them when they're watching a video or even care to stop the video for a moment and go and get their Bible and look these things up. But I'll tell you, if you look them up, you're going to see that, wow, this is what Scripture says. Not bullshit. So the moon is the faithful witness. The moon has no light of its own. It only reflects the light of the sun. Well, don't forget that the sun that God is referring to rises in the north. Isn't that weird, eh? And it's called the Sun of Righteousness. S-U-N, not S-O-N, S-U-N, the Sun of Righteousness. It is what gives life and breath to mankind. So the moon reflects no light of its own, it only reflects the light of the sun. Okay. Now the faithful witness in Scripture is the Christ, Jesus the Christ. Who admitted that he didn't speak on his own, he only spoke what his Father showed him, told him, instructed him to say. He had a Bible too, didn't he? Remember the Torah and the Psalms and the prophets? Yeah, he had a Bible too. Yeah. And everything, every word that Jesus spoke that's recorded in the New Testament comes from the Old Testament. Every miracle he performed is recorded in the Old Testament. Everything he did, everything that happened to him, everything that other people did to him, is recorded in the Old Testament. Had no light of his own, did he? He just reflected the light of the sun, of righteousness that rises in the north, the land of the ox, maturity. Okay. So when the moon is in the seventh house, there are seven spirits that stand before God. It's actually one spirit, but because God is one spirit. But it's divided into seven portions. Those seven spirits are recorded in the Old Testament and the New Testament. Yeah, I'll take the time. The spirit of grace in order of procession. The spirit of grace, the spirit of truth. This knowledge of grace and truth leading us to the spirit, the fear of the Lord, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of judgment, the spirit of counsel and power, and the spirit of fire. Those are the seven spirits that are specifically mentioned as being directly connected to God in the Old Testament. There's only those seven. Okay, Revelation will show you, talks about the seven. So when the moon, the faithful witness, when Jesus, the Christ, is in the seventh house, remember it's the counselor who is Jesus? Who teaches us, who causes us to grow and mature in Christ, in God. When the moon, when Jesus is in the seventh house is the spirit of fire. It's at Laodicea. Now, when you're reading about, I know I'm repeating old videos, all the information from old videos, but I'm going to take the time to do that for you in this one. There's seven letters to seven churches. Within the seven, each of the seven letters is contained a trumpet, an announcement, a call to pay attention, a trumpet, a seal, revealing, you crack the seal, something's revealed. So the trumpet calls you, the seal is unlocked, it reveals a message, a secret, a mystery, a revelation. A trumpet, a seal, a bowl of wrath, all of the things further on in the book of Revelation are continuing revelations of what's already been revealed in the letters to the seven churches. All of these things are contained in the seven churches, the letters, seven letters. The judgments, the plagues, everything. So when the moon is in the seventh house, when Jesus is in the spirit of fire, the fire is the truth revealed. Okay. But then it goes on and says, and Jupiter aligns with Mars. Well, if you look at the picture of the planets, you find that Jupiter is the largest of the planets. Jupiter is called the guardian planet. Who guards your life? Who guards your soul? Remember the little poem, I guess it is, you know, of the guy walking on the beach and he stumbles and everything, and he looks back at the end of his life and he sees only one set of tracks on many occasions. He sees two sets and he says, well, that's the Lord walking with me, but then he sees portions where there's only one set, and he says, it's called Footprints in the Sand, I can't quote it, but he says, you know, these are the times that the Lord carried him. Who protects us? Well, again, it's Jesus, isn't it? Who guards us? Okay. When Jupiter aligns with Mars. Now, the problem with Mars is that Mars is the red planet. Red in scripture denotes war. In many mythologies, many, many ancient religions, Mars is the warring planet. It is Aries is the god of Mars, you know, war, the god of war. So when Jupiter aligns with Mars, now these are things that are actually taking place out there in the universe, you know. Get out your telescope and your little measuring stick, you know, and then you can see all these things. You can understand them. It's a whole doctrine of study, scientific study, mathematical study. So when the Guardian lines with Mars, goes to war. Yeah. What did Jesus say? That everybody seems to forget. He said, I didn't come to bring peace. I came to bring division. Division signifies war, not peace. But when Jesus shows up on the scene, you know, the second coming, it ain't going to be a pretty sight. I mean, a lot of us will be looking forward to it, all right, you know, and we'll understand it and praise God for it, but don't think for a moment it's a pretty sight. It's not. How does it say in some places of Scripture? It talks about the iron fist, that Christ will rule with an iron fist. You know, the throne of David. No more fussing around. No more debauchery. No more screwing around. But under what circumstances?
Lovey-dovey.
Or under a fist of iron. You know, you don't need kissy-kissy, huggy-huggy, lovey-lovey to have peace. You don't. But down through the ages, you can see many, many times some very, very nasty leadership took over. And nations had peace under that kind of leadership. I give you an example. Recently, Saddam Hussein, when he ruled in Iraq, they had a booming tourist trade, they had commerce, a booming commerce, everything, you know, they had peace. And if any of the people, if the leader saw the a people as being rebellious, well, he just put them to death. Gas them. But the nation had peace. So it certainly wasn't all lovey-lovey, you know, lovey-dovey, and was it? Nope. Then peace will guide the planets, yeah? And love will steer the stars. What are the stars? In astronomy, the stars are those lighted bodies out there. But in the Bible, the stars are the saints. The stars are also something else. Remember the portion of Scripture where it talks about the Lord having seven stars in his hand? Remember the sevenfold Spirit of God? The seven letters to the seven churches steer the saints. Because the seven spirits, or the sevenfold Spirit, is that Spirit we call God. So they make out, in the New Age theory, even in the Oneness theory, they make out that this Age of Aquarius is just going to be marvelous.
wonderful.
It will be for those who understand it, recognize it. It will be for those who want to submit to Christ. It will be for those who don't have a problem calling themselves and behaving as slaves for Christ, as Paul did. They won't have any problem with it. Neither will I. But for those who want to play God, for those who want to deny God, for those who want to piss on God, it's going to be terrifying, isn't it? It's going to be worse than anything this world has ever seen. Because it won't be men fighting men. It'll be God fighting the devil and every human being who chooses to side with the devil. Remember the prophecies on Amos? What did Amos say? The day of the Lord is not a day of light. It's a day of darkness. In other words, the things that I'm showing you are going to be so forgotten, and they are already forgotten, that everybody's ignorant. I had a gentleman just last evening having a bit of discussion with a man who had some questions. And he was, you know, wondering, you know, is Israel really blind? The answer is yes. The Israel of God is those circumcised in mind and heart to truth and love. His name is Jesus. It's us. And yes, we are blind. Very few people understand any of this. They read the Bible and you've got the John Hagees and the Benny Hinns and all the people who have no maturity whatsoever.
Look what I can do.
And now the groom will recite his vows.
Oh, you offend me, Ed, saying such a thing about my favorite pastor. Yeah, well, if your favorite pastor loved you, he'd have studied the scripture, and he'd understand and be teaching the same things I'm teaching you. They don't. Or they love to play God. Come to me, and I will touch you. Really? You're God? Try a little love and show me a little truth, and he'll touch me. As far as I'm concerned, they can keep their hands off of me. Because all they're going to do is upset me, and I'm going to punch them right square in the face. Which would not be of God, I understand that. Everybody's got their demons, don't they? Yeah, I have false ideas. Yeah, well, that wouldn't do any good, punching those assholes in the face. I give them the truth and let the truth condemn them. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. Not Ed's. Vengeance belongs to God. I just tell them the truth and let God deal with them. I know what God's judgments are. They're recorded in Scripture, and they're not nice. They're not nice. God is not some pushover little pansy who runs around kissing everybody's ass. God is terrifying. You piss him off, it's not funny. Now, if you don't believe me, try putting your hand on a red-hot stove element. Truth warns you, don't touch. Go ahead and touch it. I don't care what magic trick you've got to try and protect your hands. Go ahead and touch it. You're going to burn. Really bad. Really bad. You don't mess with truth. You don't tell truth what to do. Truth has finished his creation. Has been finished for a long, long time. And he calls us to be at rest with that. Stop trying to recreate what he's already created. Be his witnesses to his identity and give glory to him. Stop trying to play God. So anyways, I thought you might enjoy listening to this. Maybe you don't. I don't know. Let me know. Let me know. Give me a thumbs up or whatever. You know, I don't care. Leave me a comment. Don't play the New Age game. It ain't worth it. It ain't worth it. And remember this, no man is righteous, no, not one. People think they're righteous. They think they're doing the right things, that they're behaving properly and everything. Believe you me, we haven't got a clue. And we'll never come close to God in his righteousness. But we are given the gift of understanding. And we take hold of Jesus' righteousness. It's not our righteousness. It's not what we do. It's what he's already done for us. And we take hold and we hold on to that. That's our hope. That's our promise. Jesus died for my sins. He died for your sins. If I love him enough to search for him and I find him and I love him enough to confess publicly every time, all the time, that he's Lord. There's only one God, and he's it. And yet God has a mind of his own, full of truth, has a heart of his own, full of love, and has a form of his own. That form is Jesus. It's not you, and it's not me. It's Jesus, the Messiah, the Christ. If we remember these things, the promise is he will save us. So I stand on the promises of Christ my Lord. I don't stand on my own abilities to save myself by acting like I'm God, by trying to teach other people that they can grow until they become gods. Fat chance of that happening. Even in heaven, who's going to be boss? Jesus the form? No, sorry. No. Jesus, when it's all said and done, when it's finished, when the devil is destroyed and all who follow him, when falsehood is gone, out of the equation altogether, on the other side of death, because death is of the devil, on the other side of death, then Jesus hands the kingdom over to the Father, that the Father may be all in all. Truth and love in everything and in us. On the other side. Does that make us God? Nope. I didn't create the universe. I didn't make all this. I don't control all this. Neither do you. Man is not God. And Jesus is not a man. Jesus is God in flesh. He's the Messiah. Jesus is Lord. Do what he asked. Love one another. Bye for now.